We've prepared really hard this whole season for championships. What we're expecting is for our girls to compete at a really high level. I really want to see our girls post personal best again. 2 years ago, we had an outstanding conference meet where our girls just swam unbelievably fast. I feel we put the work in this year to see the same results, and I'm really looking forward to seeing those results.
Going into this weekend, I think that the expectations for the team are very positive, especially after watching the Middlebury girls swim at the Middlebury Invite for their championships. They swam so fast. They did absolutely amazingly, and we definitely can see that we're going to swim just as fast since we're going through the same taper as they did, and we're very excited for it.
We've stopped lifting. We've definitely brought it down. We haven't done as many morning practices. Now we're not doing any. So now it's more about sprinting and not as much yardage. So we definitely brought it down to stay rested.
Really focusing on the fine details, good starts, good turns, good balance in the water. Just trying to fine tune those little things that'll make the difference in their races.
Definitely throughout the year in our dual meets, you compete as a team and you cheer each other on and you think more of it as a team mentality. Whereas for championships, it's a little more individually based because you have your one event amongst many others and it's not all against your teammates. And you have to focus on that race so that you can get points for the team, especially if you come back. But even though we're still there as a team and we cheer for each other, but it's very centralized and it's very individually focused, but in a team setting.
It's definitely exhausting because most meets are only one day. But the good thing is that most people only have one event per day, and the dual meets all year, we have three, maybe four events per day. So it's harder in some ways, but at the same time, you can focus on one event per day, which is really nice.
In terms of placing, it's really anybody's game right now. The top two teams, BU and UMBC on the women's side, are really going to be knocking it out pretty good. UNH is exceptionally strong this year, so they're going to be right in the mix. You know, and I feel, you know, UMBC, Binghamton, Stony Brook, and Vermont, Binghamton and Stony Brook have gotten much better in 1 year. So it's going to be interesting, kind of in that third to fifth place spot. We're really going to be battling it out pretty good in there. It's going to come down to what do our bottom kids really do. Do they get in and do they score, and how high do they score? And do we force out those other teams from scoring positions?